America's first attempt to launch a satellite, a 6.5-inch sphere weighing just over 3 pounds, was checked out by scientists and declared ready. A great wave of advanced publicity focused attention at Cape Canaveral, Florida. Another setback for the United States in the race into outer space. A loss of thrust and fall back to Earth in split seconds.
Florida, the Army's Jupiter C rocket is readied for America's second attempt to launch a space satellite. No relation to the IRBM Jupiter, this is a rebuilt Redstone, a 200-mile missile carrying, instead of a warhead, 3 stages of solid-fuel booster rockets and the Explorer, only inches across, crammed with electronic gear. 30 pounds of payload. The moment is at hand, the countdown reaches zero. Some 3 minutes later, Explorer is in orbit, broadcasting to the world its coded scientific data.
T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, ignition,
liftoff,
all right, liftoff,
astronaut AOK,
periscope is coming out, and the turnaround has started.
But why, some say, the moon? Why choose this as our goal? And they may well ask, why climb the highest mountain? Why, 35 years ago, fly the Atlantic? Why does Rice play Texas? We choose to go to the moon. We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other things, not because they are easy, but because they are hard.
Thank you.
The Eagle has landed.
It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.